get into the system. It should give us a better idea of what's going on in there.
Stay out of my way.
The data's uploading now. There's a reference of something called Icarus. It says here that it was a bioengineering program that started in 1973. Probably while health issues related to microgravity, loss of muscle mass, bone density, shit like that.
Imagine what will happen if we end up with a full-scale revolt.
allowed into the area except for emergency personnel. We've been unable to confirm the precise nature of the crisis, although at least one official has suggested that it may involve terrorism. Let's go to Diego Rodriguez, live on the scene.
Thanks, Bill. We're being told that just before 5 p.m. today, gunfire was reported at the downtown headquarters of Armacam Technology Corporation, a major defense contractor. Now, what followed is unclear at this point. U.S. Army helicopters were seen approaching the building, but we've heard nothing since. Police are urging citizens to remain at home and say there is very little danger of the situation spreading outside of the cordoned area. Phil, back to you.
That was Diego Rodriguez coming to us live from the police blockade downtown. Today's crisis at Armacam comes on the heels of a report that one of its vice presidents was kidnapped at gunpoint this morning on his way to work. Police are refusing to speculate as to whether the events are connected.
Remotely once I'm logged in.
No, you can't. It's on a separate network.